If you've spent some time making screens before, you'll know that most of your time is spent adding structures and arranging the model exactly as you want it. This tip can help you cut down on that time. From the hub, clicking on the Atlas button will bring you to the Gray's Anatomy screen series. These screens are made to mirror the images that are present in the Gray's Atlas of Anatomy textbook, but in 3D. Using them as a template to make a screen is easy as they will often contain many of the relevant structures related to your teaching objective. For example, if I want to make a screen showing the brachial plexus, I can use the search bar to find the Gray's screen that's relevant to this content. Here are a number of screens that might be useful. I'll use this one as all of the nerves are in it. Clicking X in the top right corner opens this arrangement of structures in the editing window. I can make whatever changes I want to this setup to make it my own, and then save it, ready for use in the lecture or a lab. We touched on labels in the last video, but there are a couple of other things you can use the labels to do. Clicking on an individual structure will add a label to the screen. Long clicking on that structure will open a group label. These are useful to highlight a group of structures together. Lastly, a free text label allows you to enter your own text into the window. Double clicking on a structure will open a free text window. This is useful if the name of the structure given in the app has too much detail, or if I don't want to give my students the name of a structure, but want to bring their attention to it.